Dearly beloved brethren, the scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with an humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by his infinite goodness and mercy. And although we ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we most chiefly so to do when we assemble and meet together to render thanks for the great benefits that we have received at his hands, to set forth his most worthy praise, to hear his most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary as well for the body as the soul. Wherefore I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying after me, Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and there is no help in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them with our penitence, according to thy promises declared unto mankind in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live in godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather that he may turn from his wickedness and live, and hath given power and commandment to his ministers to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardoneth and absolveth all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore, let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. 483. Jesu, my Lord, my God, my Lord.
Thank you. the ninth chapter of the book of Proverbs, beginning at the first verse. Wisdom has built her house. She has hewn her seven pillars. She has slaughtered her animals. She has mixed her wine. She has also set her table. She has sent out her servant girls. She calls from the high places in the town, "You that are simple, turn in here." To those without sense, she says, "Come, eat of my bread and drink of the wine I have mixed." Here ends the lesson.
Thank you.
ninth chapter of the Gospel according to Luke,
beginning at the 11th verse. When the crowds found out about it, they followed him, and he welcomed them, and spoke to them about the kingdom of God, and healed those who needed to be cured. The day was drawing to a close, and the 12 came to him and said, "Send the crowd away, so that they may go into the surrounding villages and countryside to lodge and get provisions, for we are here in a deserted place." But he said to them, "You give them something to eat." They said, "We have no more than 5 loaves and 2 fish, unless we are to go and buy food for all these people." For there were about 5,000 men. And he said to his disciples, "Make them sit down in groups of about 50 each." They did so, and made them all sit down. And taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven, and blessed and broke them, and gave them to the disciples to set before the crowd. And all ate and were filled. What was left over was gathered up, 12 baskets of broken pieces. Here ends the lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered in the Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Christ, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us.
from the movement book we stand to sing the first part of hymn number 316. Now, my song, the mystery telling of the glorious body of sin. Pray to the Lord our God in the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ, empowered by his Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear us. Lord, hear the prayers of your people gathered in your presence, gathered at your temple. Here, where we celebrate how Christ gave us his body to be our spiritual food. Listen, Lord, as we pray for his body, the church, spread throughout the world. For our brothers and sisters scattered by oppression and persecution, unable to break bread together. For ecumenical friends here in Stourbridge and across the world. For mission partners serving your kingdom in many lands. Lord, hear us. Lord, gracious will you hear us. Here where we recognize the presence of Christ who takes away the sin of the world. Listen as we pray for that world and for its peoples, for whom its blood was shed. For peace between the warring nations of the world. For justice for those innocents caught up in the ambitions of the powerful. Those born into poverty. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Here, where we come together as Christ gathered with his friends to give us this meal of holy fellowship, listen, Lord, as we pray for all whom you have given us, for our friends, and all whose lives are joined with ours. For provision against the needs of our families and our friends. For all that our neighbours bring to us and receive from us. And in thanksgiving for all that we benefit through living in community. Lord, hear us. Lord, gracious. Here where we remember the night of Christ's agony and trial. Listen, Lord, as we pray for all who share his sufferings through fear or pain or distress of many kinds. Comfort for all those afflicted by injury or disease. For consolation for all afflicted by fear, confusion or loss. For peace for all at the end of their earthly lives. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
graciously hear us. Here, where we join our praises with the whole company of heaven, listen, Lord, as we pray for all who have trusted Christ's promise to raise up on the last day those who eat his flesh and drink his blood. pray in thanksgiving for those whom we have loved but see no longer, for those who drew us deeper into the knowledge of your love for us, for all who gave up their earthly lives for the sake of the faith. Lord, hear us. Lord, grant us forgiveness. Lord, satisfy our hunger with the food that lasts, the bread of God which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and thus promise that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests, fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for thee, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen. We stand to sing, All for Jesus, All for Jesus, as our song shall ever be, number 277.
Thank you.
before I pronounce the blessing, can I just say thank you to the choir for enabling our worship this evening? It's been magnificent. And to Almighty God for proving that things impossible can be made possible. The Lord be with you. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of the Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Thank you.